The National Weather Service in Grand Rapids has issued a tropical storm watch for all of western Michigan. A tropical storm watch means that tropical storm conditions, which are sustained winds of 39 miles per hour or higher associated with a tropical storm, are possible within 48 hours. Tropical Depression 10 has formed over northern Lake Michigan based on satellite VORC estimation and recent recon data. Tropical storm force winds are possible Saturday night into Tuesday morning. As of the 5 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time advisory, Tropical Depression 10 is located 50 miles west of Traverse City, Michigan. Currently stationary. Maximum sustained winds are near 35 miles per hour, with higher gusts on its current track. Tropical Depression 10 is forecast to strengthen into a tropical storm later today, with landfall expected Monday afternoon before turning towards the west towards Chicago. Storm surge of 2 to 4 feet is expected along the coast. Monitor all local media and NOAA Weather Radio for the latest information. Tropical storm conditions possible along the Great Lakes from newly formed Tropical Storm Jerry. Tropical storm watch remains in effect until the National Weather Service in Grand Rapids has issued a hurricane watch for all of western Michigan. A hurricane watch means that hurricane conditions, which are winds of 64 knots or 74 miles per hour or greater, are expected within the next 48 hours. Tropical Storm Jerry is expected to impact West Michigan within the next 72 hours. Tropical storm force winds are expected to start on Saturday, with hurricane force winds expected to start Sunday afternoon and lasting until Monday evening. Storm surge of 4 to 6 feet is expected along the lake shore. All boaters are advised to report back to port by Friday afternoon before the onset of tropical storm conditions on Saturday. Tropical Storm Jerry currently has maximum sustained winds of 50 miles per hour, with gusts up to 65 miles per hour. On the current forecast track, Jerry is expected to make landfall near South Haven, Michigan, paralleling the coast, before turning west towards Chicago, with a second landfall as a Category 2 hurricane with winds of 105 miles per hour expected. Be prepared to evacuate once a hurricane warning is issued, or once told by local authorities. The National Weather Service in Grand Rapids has issued a hurricane warning for the following counties in West Michigan: Van Buren, Kalamazoo, Allegan, Barrie, Ottawa, Kent, Muskegon, Newego, Oshawa, Messon, and Lake. At 11 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time, the eye of Hurricane Jerry was located near latitude 43.69 north, 87.06 west, or about 31 miles south-southwest of Pentwater, Michigan, moving south at 1 mile per hour. Jerry is currently a dangerous Category 2 hurricane, with winds up to 100 miles per hour, gusting to 120 miles per hour. Jerry has been moving slowly to the south at 1 mile per hour for the past several hours. It is expected that the forward motion of Jerry will increase to at least 4 miles per hour within the next 12 to 24 hours. Hurricane Jerry is expected to make landfall near South Haven, Michigan on Sunday, with winds of up to 120 miles per hour. Jerry will weaken very little after landfall before turning to the west towards Chicago, where it is expected to attain winds of up to 140 miles per hour before making a final landfall. 8 to 14 feet of storm surge is expected along the coast. If you are along the coast, it is advised that you evacuate immediately. Stay tuned to the station and other media outlets for more information.
I can't get out. Try to talk, but there's no sound. Ears are shut, but the world's too loud. All my dreams are washed somehow.
The National Weather Service in Grand Rapids has issued a flash flood watch for all of western Michigan until 12 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time on Thursday, September 19. This is a particularly dangerous situation. Hurricane Jerry has been slowly moving to the south, and has been growing in size due to eye wall replacement cyclones. These eye wall replacement cyclones will create a wider area of heavy rainfall across western Michigan as the storm continues to widen and intensify. Rainfall amounts of 20 to 30 inches are expected, with the potential of some areas to exceed 40 inches of rain. This will cause widespread, catastrophic flooding, comparable to flooding seen during Hurricanes Harvey and Florence. The rain will start in the area Saturday morning, and continue to fall into Wednesday of next week. Even after the rain stops, some rivers may continue to rise, and not crest, until after the rain stops. If this is expected to verify, the flash flood watch may need to be extended beyond Thursday morning. A flash flood watch means that conditions may develop that lead to flash flooding. Flash flooding is a very dangerous situation. You should monitor later forecasts and be prepared to take action should flash flood warnings be issued.
The National Weather Service in Detroit Pontiac has issued tornado watch number 231 for all of southeast Michigan until 10 a.m. EDT on September 15. The outer bands of Hurricane Jerry will start spreading into southeast Michigan as the storm continues to grow in size and strength. There is an increasing risk of tornadoes in the stronger cells in the coming squalls. The tornado watch area consists of southeast Michigan south of the Interstate 69 corridor, where the greatest tornado threat exists. While many tornadoes will be generally weak, there is the potential that a few tornadoes could be EF2 strength or stronger. Remember, a tornado watch means that conditions are favorable for tornadoes and severe thunderstorms in and close to the watch area. Persons in these areas should be on the lookout for threatening weather. The National Weather Service in Detroit Pontiac has issued tornado watch number 231 for all of southeast Michigan until 10 a.m. EDT on September 15. The outer bands of Hurricane Jerry will start spreading into southeast Michigan as the storm continues to grow in size and strength. There is an increasing risk of tornadoes in the stronger cells in the coming squalls. The tornado watch area consists of southeast Michigan south of the Interstate 69 corridor, where the greatest tornado threat exists. While many tornadoes will be generally weak, there is the potential that a few tornadoes could be EF2 strength or stronger. Remember, a tornado watch means that conditions are favorable for tornadoes and severe thunderstorms in and close to the watch area. Persons in these areas should be on the lookout for threatening weather. Now here is the latest information on Hurricane Jerry. As of 8 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time on September 14th, Jerry is an extremely dangerous Category 3 hurricane, with winds up to 125 miles per hour, and gusts up to 150 miles per hour. Tropical storm force winds extend out 145 miles from the center, while hurricane force winds extend out 40 miles from the center. Jerry has continued to strengthen despite continued eyewall replacement cyclones, and Jerry is expected to make landfall in South Haven, Michigan tomorrow, with winds up to 145 miles per hour. The storm will then hug the coastline for up to 5 hours, changing little in strength, then turning to the west, where additional intensification is expected, and Jerry is forecast to make landfall in Chicago at Category 5 strength, with winds up to 160 miles per hour. Jerry will then move inland and stall as it turns to the south-southeast, slowly weakening. Rainfall totals from Jerry will potentially exceed 45 inches, where the rainfall is heaviest. This will lead to catastrophic and historic flooding, with many rivers forecast to go well beyond record flood stages. Storm surge of 12 to 18 feet is expected along the Lake Michigan coast.
Tornado emergency for the northern metro Detroit area. This is a particularly dangerous situation. Point: the National Weather Service in Detroit Pontiac has issued a tornado warning for the following counties in southeast Michigan: Livingston and Wayne, until 11:35 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time. At 10:39 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time, a confirmed large and extremely dangerous tornado was located 5 miles southwest of Novi, moving northeast at 25 miles per hour. This is a tornado emergency for the northern metro Detroit area. This is an extremely dangerous and life-threatening situation. Take cover now. Hazard: deadly tornado. Source: law enforcement and the public. Confirm large wedge tornado, with reports of catastrophic damage near Plymouth Township, Michigan. Impact: you are in a life-threatening situation. Flying debris will be deadly to those caught without shelter. Mobile homes will be destroyed. Considerable damage to homes, businesses, and vehicles is likely, and complete destruction is possible. Locations impacted include Novi, Farmington Hills, West Bloomfield Township, Franklin, Bloomfield Township, Bloomfield Hills, and Pontiac. To repeat, a large, extremely dangerous, and potentially deadly tornado is on the ground. To protect your life, take cover now. Move to a basement or an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Avoid windows. If you are outdoors, in a mobile home, or in a vehicle, move to the closest substantial shelter and protect yourself from flying debris. A large and extremely dangerous tornado is on the ground. Take immediate tornado precautions. This is an emergency situation. Flash flood emergency for the Grand Rapids area. The National Weather Service in Grand Rapids has issued a flash flood warning for the following counties in West Michigan, Kent, Allegan, Ottawa, and Muskegon, until 10:30 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. At 1:18 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, National Weather Service Doppler radar indicated heavy rain across the warned area. Life-threatening flash flooding is already occurring. This is a flash flood emergency for the Grand Rapids metropolitan area. Seek higher ground now. Some locations that will experience flooding include downtown Grand Rapids, Wyoming, Grandville, Comstock Park, Eda, Forest Hills, Allendale Charter Township, Pocan Charter Township, Spring Lake, Ferrisburg, and Grand Haven. Move to higher ground now. This is an extremely dangerous and life-threatening situation. Do not attempt to travel unless you are fleeing an area subject to flooding or are under an evacuation order. Be especially cautious at night when it is harder to recognize the dangers of flooding. A flash flood warning means that flooding is imminent or occurring. If you are in the warned area, move to higher ground immediately. Residents living along streams and creeks should take immediate precautions to protect life and property.
Latest information on Hurricane Jerry at 8 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time on September 14, 2019. Advisory 9A. Hurricane Jerry is currently an extremely dangerous Category 4 hurricane, with winds around 145 miles per hour, and gusts up to 175 miles per hour. Tropical storm force winds extend out 207 miles from the center, while hurricane force winds extend out 56 miles from the center. Jerry is currently moving south at 3 miles per hour, and is expected to maintain this pace for the next several hours. On the current track, Jerry is expected to continue to intensify up until landfall in South Haven, Michigan, where Jerry is now forecast to make landfall as a Category 5 with winds up to 165 miles per hour. The first landfall is expected to occur between 9 a.m. and noon on Sunday. Jerry will weaken slightly after making landfall, with winds decreasing to 155 miles per hour, before emerging back over the extremely warm lake waters and re-intensifying over Lake Michigan to attain winds of 190 miles per hour just before landfall in Chicago. After landfall in Chicago, the storm will slowly move inland and stall as it turns to the southeast, where the storm's forward motion is expected to increase and potentially emerge over the Atlantic by mid to late week next week as a tropical storm. Hazards: winds of 160 miles per hour or greater will cause tornado-like damage to homes and businesses. Storm surge of 14 to 20 feet is expected, in addition to severe seas after the storm.
It is currently 9 a.m. here in West Michigan. Good morning. I am meteorologist Mike Bryant bringing you the continuing coverage of Hurricane Jerry. As of the latest advisory we have gotten from the National Hurricane Center, Jerry currently has winds of 155 miles per hour with gusts up to 180 miles per hour, and the center was located 15 miles west of Saugatuck, Michigan, moving to the south-southeast at 4 miles per hour. We already have very dangerous conditions occurring along the coastline today. We have a report out of St. Joseph that there is a storm surge of 9.25 feet, and another report out of South Haven of a storm surge of 14.5 feet already, likely causing catastrophic flooding and making river flooding worse as the water is unable to drain into the lake due to the onshore flow. The storm is currently centered 22 miles away from South Haven, and if we calculate the current forward motion of the storm at 4 miles per hour, and if it maintains that speed, we are looking at landfall in South Haven in 5.5 hours from now. The National Weather Service is likely considering an extreme wind warning for the area at this time. That will likely be issued very soon if that is true. The warning would cover any area expected to be impacted by the eyewall of the hurricane. The eyewall should be coming ashore in about 3 hours from now, bringing destructive winds in excess of 155 miles per hour. If you are in the path of the eye and eyewall, you need to be treating the situation as if a tornado was approaching, and you will need to be getting underground immediately. If you cannot get underground for whatever reason, then your next best option would be to get into an interior room in the most central part of your building away from windows. Put as many walls between you and the outside as possible. Do not stay in mobile homes. Do not stay in mobile homes, as mobile homes will likely be swept completely off their foundations in these winds. These winds are roughly the equivalent of a high-end EF3 to a low-end EF4 tornado and are capable of causing heavy damage. As of now, the hurricane has claimed the lives of 27 people and injured more than 239 others. We will now go to South Haven, where...
The National Weather Service in Grand Rapids has issued an extreme wind warning for southwestern Allegan County and western Van Buren County until 3:45 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. At 9:01 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time, National Weather Service Doppler radar indicated extreme winds in excess of 145 miles per hour, associated with the eyewall of Hurricane Jerry, were moving on shore. This is an extremely dangerous and life-threatening situation. Take cover now. Treat these imminent extreme winds as if a tornado was approaching, and move immediately to the safe room in your shelter. Take action now to protect your life. The safest place to be during a major landfalling hurricane is in a reinforced interior room away from windows, or in a basement, if one is available. Get under a table or other piece of sturdy furniture. Use mattresses, blankets, or pillows to cover your head and body. Remain in place through the passage of these life-threatening conditions.
This is your weather radio station WWF 34 inches Plainwell, operating on a frequency of 162.475 MHz. Programming originates from the National Weather Service Forecast Office in Grand Rapids, Michigan. This is Plainwell Weather Radio, and here is the latest information on Hurricane Jerry, Advisory Number 12, issued at 2 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. Hurricane Jerry has made landfall in South Haven, Michigan, with winds of up to 165 miles per hour and wind gusts up to 195 miles per hour, and a minimum pressure of 908 millibars. The center of Hurricane Jerry is currently over South Haven, Michigan, moving south at 4 miles per hour. Tropical storm force winds extend out 230 miles, while hurricane force winds extend out 60 miles. On the current track, Hurricane Jerry is expected to turn towards the west within the next few hours, and emerge over the warm waters of Lake Michigan later this afternoon. Some slight weakening is possible while the center of Jerry is just inland. Jerry is expected to rapidly intensify over Lake Michigan, attaining winds of 195 miles per hour, just before making landfall in Chicago. After landfall, the storm will slowly crawl inland, and make a turn towards the south, then turn east, While forward motion increases, the current forecast track has Jerry remaining a hurricane all the way into the Ohio Valley due to brown ocean effect. Jerry is then expected to emerge over the Atlantic by mid to late week as a tropical storm, where the storm has the potential to re-strengthen. Hazards affecting our area. Hurricane Jerry is currently bringing winds up to 165 miles per hour to parts of West Michigan, causing potentially catastrophic structural damage. A storm surge of 15 to 20 feet is being pushed ashore, with the potential of post-storm seiches happening due to the displacement of water from the storm. Stay tuned to NOAA Weather Radio and other media outlets for more information on Hurricane Jerry. Now here are the latest observations from
If you are just joining us here on Wood TV 8, Hurricane Jerry has made landfall in South Haven roughly an hour ago. Due to the slow forward motion of the storm, South Haven is now in the eye of the storm, and we are getting a first look at the damage that has occurred in the South Haven area. As we look at this picture of the damage, it looks like there is major roof damage to the structure right here, and I think I can see some homes that have been completely destroyed already. I hope people do not stay out in the eye of the storm for a long period of time because they will still have to deal with the second half of the eye wall shortly, which could do even more damage to structures that have already been damaged from the first half of the eye wall. The storm is continuing to move on a painfully slow track towards the south, with a turn towards the west expected within the next few hours.
The following message is transmitted at the request of the Michigan Emergency Management Association. Catastrophic damage has been reported across parts of Allegan, Van Buren, and Berrien counties. Homes have been reported to be heavily damaged or destroyed in South Haven. In addition, many trees have been snapped in the mentioned areas, blocking many roadways. As of 3 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, the eye of Hurricane Jerry is currently over Covert, Michigan, and still has maximum sustained winds of 165 miles per hour, with higher gusts. The threat of extreme winds is expected to continue in the area for the next few hours, and an extreme wind warning remains in effect for Van Buren and Berrien counties until 5:45 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. For your protection, remain sheltered in your house, and keep away from all exterior doors and windows. Do not attempt to travel in extreme winds. Traveling in these conditions is extremely hazardous due to falling trees and flying debris, which can be deadly. Remain indoors until dangerous conditions pass, and do not mistake the eye of the hurricane as the end of the storm. Do not be outside for long periods of time, if in the eye of the hurricane, as you will deal with the other half of the eye wall soon afterwards. Stay tuned to this station and other media outlets for more information on this dangerous situation. The following message is transmitted at the request of Cook County Emergency Management. This is a mandatory evacuation order for the Chicago area along Lake Michigan. Hurricane Jerry is headed towards the Chicago metropolitan area and is expected to make landfall tomorrow evening as a Category 5 hurricane with winds up to 195 miles per hour. This is an extremely dangerous situation and should not be ignored. All coastal areas in a storm surge area need to be evacuated immediately. Storm surge flooding is already being reported in some coastal areas in Chicago. All residents in an evacuation area need to pack essential supplies before evacuating, including a first aid kit, food and water to last you and your family for 3 days, a flashlight, and a battery-powered radio. It is also advised that you tie a white towel to your mailbox before evacuating. This will let authorities know that you are aware of the situation and that you have evacuated the area. Stay tuned to this station and other media outlets for more information on this dangerous situation.
I know you feel like you want me, and I guess in a way you do. Holding my breath, unraveling emotions. I need some space to think this through. Call me all night long. Try to give you hints in a hard to see. Right on the so you won't see, cause the pain is in my eyes. Feels like I could break at any moment and shatter your insides. If you feel my mind, call me all night long. Try to give you hints in a hard to see. Right on the
flash flood emergency for Cook County. A flash flood warning remains in effect until 3:30 a.m. Central Daylight Time on September 17. At 10:41 a.m. Central Daylight Time, Doppler radar indicated heavy rainfall across the warned area. Widespread amounts of 25 to 35 inches of rain have fallen. Flash flooding is already occurring. Law enforcement has reported several roads and neighborhoods underwater. This is a flash flood emergency for Cook County. This is a particularly dangerous situation. Seek higher ground now. Some locations that will experience flooding include downtown Chicago, McKinley Park, Little Village, Bartown, Evanston, Logan Square, Lincoln Park, and River North. Move to higher ground now. Do not drive into flooded areas. This is an extremely dangerous and life-threatening situation. Do not attempt to travel unless you are fleeing an area subject to flooding or under an evacuation order. The National Weather Service in Chicago has issued an extreme wind warning for all of Cook County, Lake County, and eastern DuPage County until 11:45 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 5:05 p.m. Central Daylight Time, National Weather Service Doppler radar indicated extreme winds in excess of 185 miles per hour, associated with the eyewall of Hurricane Jerry, were moving on shore. This is a potential mass casualty situation. Flying debris will be deadly to those caught without shelter. Mobile homes will be completely swept from their foundations. Homes and businesses may be completely swept from their foundations. Trees will be uprooted or snapped. Debris will block most roadways. Complete destruction of entire neighborhoods is possible, making the area unrecognizable to survivors. Take cover now. Treat these imminent extreme winds as if a tornado was approaching, and move immediately to the safe room in your shelter. Widespread destructive winds of 180 to 210 miles per hour will be spreading across northern Illinois, producing swaths of tornado-like damage. Take action now to protect your life.
Here is the latest update on Hurricane Jerry. Hurricane Jerry has made landfall in Chicago as an extremely dangerous Category 5 hurricane, with winds up to 200 miles per hour and a minimum pressure of 888 millibars on its current forecast track. Jerry is expected to slowly move inland, slowly weakening before turning south, and then accelerating to the south-southeast. Jerry will maintain hurricane status into the Ohio Valley due to the influence of a strong brown ocean effect. Jerry is then expected to emerge into the Atlantic as a tropical storm by late week. Hazards for our area: continued extreme winds of 190 to 205 miles per hour can be expected throughout the next few hours while the storm slowly weakens. Storm surge of 18 to 26 feet is expected in coastal areas. Rainfall totals due to the slow movement of Jerry are expected to be in the 30 to 40 inch range, with some areas approaching 50 inches of rain. This will cause catastrophic and historic flooding. Impacts on this scale are unheard of in this region, and forecasting the full extent of the impacts of flooding is unable to be forecasted.
The following message is transmitted at the request of the Cook County Emergency Management. Hurricane Jerry has caused catastrophic damage across the Chicago metropolitan area, which ranges from blown-out windows and skyscrapers to homes being completely swept from foundations by storm surge, flash flooding, or extreme winds. So far, over 600 people have been reported to be killed in the Chicago area, and approximately 1,400 injured, with these numbers likely to rise in the coming hours and days. The entire Chicago metropolitan area is without electricity, and 60% of the area is without running water. If you are in the Chicago metropolitan area, keep listening to your local news and radio stations for the locations of shelters. If your home has been heavily damaged or destroyed, please head to these shelters to be safe. Stay tuned to this station or other media outlets for more information on the situation. The National Weather Service in Indianapolis has issued an extreme wind warning for the following counties: Marion, Hendricks, Boone, Hamilton, and Hancock, until 1:15 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time on September 18th, at 8:35 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. National Weather Service Doppler radar indicated extreme winds in excess of 115 miles per hour, associated with the eyewall of Hurricane Jerry, were approaching the warned counties. This is an extremely dangerous and life-threatening situation. Widespread destructive winds of 110 to 135 miles per hour will spread across parts of Marion County, Hendricks County, Boone County, Hamilton County, and Hancock County. Take cover now. Treat these imminent extreme winds as if a tornado was approaching, and move immediately to a basement or an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Stay away from windows. If in a mobile home, relocate to a substantial shelter to keep safe. Take action now to protect your life. The National Weather Service in Wilmington has issued an extreme wind warning for the following counties in Ohio, Butler and Hamilton, and for the following counties in Indiana, Franklin, until 4:45 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time. At 12:32 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time, surface observations and Doppler radar indicated extreme winds, associated with the eyewall of Hurricane Jerry, were about to cross the state line into Ohio, and moving south-southeast at 15 miles per hour. This is an extremely dangerous and life-threatening situation. Frequent destructive wind gusts of 115 to 125 miles per hour will spread across the warned area. A wind gust of 126 miles per hour was recorded in Brookville, Indiana. Take cover now. Treat these imminent extreme winds as if a tornado was approaching, and move immediately to a basement or an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Take action now to protect your life. The following message is transmitted at the request of Marion County Emergency Management. Severe damage has occurred across Marion County due to the passage of Hurricane Jerry last night. Widespread roof damage to homes and businesses has occurred in and around Indianapolis, and windows and skyscrapers have been blown out. Many trees have also been blown down, blocking roadways. In addition, 600,000 customers are without power in Marion County due to damage to power lines. Due to the current situation, it is possible that power might not be restored for days. Residents are being advised to prepare for the possibility of a long-term power outage around Marion County and to get adequate supplies to prepare for this. It should also be noted that caution should be taken when attempting to travel due to debris in roadways. Stay tuned to this station and other media outlets for more information on the situation.